Good afternoon children, welcome you all to the science video section standard 3. To continue the lesson animal life, lesson 2 animal life. Previous videos we see about many things. Today video we discuss about some important topic, so listen carefully. Children, do you know the parts in your mouth? In the mouth they have lips, tongue, teeth. Then teeth. Do you know the uses of teeth? They cut and chew the food stuff. Are all the teeth have the same size and shapes? Right? Yes. The teeth have different shapes and size based on their function. Today we will learn more about these mouth parts. Today we learn about mouth parts of the animal. Mouth parts are different parts of mouth that are adapted based on the nature of the food that the animal eats. Okay, first animal is elephant. Elephant uses trunk for picking up food and sucking water. So they use a different way. Then dog and cats lick liquid with the help of their tongue. So they present in the mouth part. Next, butterfly. They have a tube-like structure. The best is it's a straw shape. So they suck the nectar from flower. This animal here using the mouth this way. Then mosquito have a needle shaped mouth like structure to suck blood. Then lizard and frog have a sticky tongue to catch insect. So every animal using their mouth part in the different way. We are using the mouth part for cutting and chewing the food. Teeth helps to cutting and tongue tell to taste. Lips tell to open the mouth. Okay, this is the power function. This is the animal parts of the function. Next we see about birds. Birds are also known as apes. Now we see the characters of birds. Birds have the feathers, toothless, peaked jaw, laying of hard shelled egg, the high metabolic rate, a four-chamber heart. We also have the four-chamber heart. A strong yet lightweight skeleton. Okay, this is the characters of the bird. Have you ever wondered why birds have the beak of different shapes and size? Now we discuss about beak of birds. Every bird have different beak. First picture of the bird is name is eagle, right? The eagle. Eagle have strong, sharp, curved beak and tear the flesh. They helps to tear the flesh. So only they have the curved beak. Next, second picture of the bird name is kingfisher. This is the picture of the kingfisher bird. The kingfisher bird have pear beak. Look like pear beak. They helps to fish eating. This bird is called fish eating bird. Okay. Next bird, parrot. This picture bird is parrot. Parrot. I like parrot. I like the beak of the parrot. They sharp. They hooked. Who sharp beak helps to collect and eat the grains. I like the parrot beak. Next bird is woodpecker. Woodpecker's main work is put the hole in the wood of the tree and in that wood they have some insect. They eat that insect. Okay. The strong shrill beak is used to make hole in the tree and catch the insect. So only they have that type of beak. Next, this picture contains that bird name? Sparrow. Sparrow, the short and conical beak, which helps to crack open the shell of the seeds or nuts. Okay. Next bird is duck. Duck have flat beak that helps to grip plant and insect from water. This is the different bird have the different types of beaks. Okay. Have you wonder now? Good. Next we discuss about food chain and food web. Food chain means food chain, they transfer energy from one thing to another. Here grass give energy to grasshopper, then grasshopper give energy to rat, rat give energy to eagle. This is a food chain. Food web means every the many connecting of food chain. That is a food web. Now we discuss more about that. First, food chain. Food chain transfer the energy from one living things to another living thing. Energy flow in living things. Plant, animal together form a chain of relationship or amount of food habits known as food chain. See, the food chain start with plant. That is a producer means plants only, you know, green plants produce, make their own food. That food was eaten by consumers, that is animals, plant and animal eaters. So plant eaten by herbivorous animal only. So his name is grasshopper. Then grasshopper eaten by snake, the snake eaten by eagle. These are also animals, they are also consumers. This is from a relationship. So the, after the death of these animals, they decomposes. They are going to decompose it by microorganisms. Then they give energy. They store the. They decompose means their nutrition. They transfer into nutrition. The nutrition helps to plant prepare their own food. So this is a whole food chain. Food chain is the representation of the flow of energy through nutrients and food habits in living things. Okay. Your food chain usually start with the plants and ends with animals or other herbivorous or omnivorous animal. The interdependence among living things and dependence on non-living things. Okay. This is a plan. Food chain always start with the, now we see one example. Food chain always start with the plant. That is producer is the plant, that is a grass. Then first level consumer. This consumer also animal, right? This is an insect. They start with insects. Grasshopper. Then second level consumer is snake. This is a food chain on land is referred to as a terrestrial food chain. Okay, that is a snake. It's also an animal. Okay, this is a carnivorous animal. Then eagle, the third level consumer. Eagle eat the snake. So grass give energy to grasshopper. Grasshopper give energy to snake. Snake give energy to eagle. Likewise, energy transfer from plant to other animals, other living things. This is a food chain. Okay. See another example. Producer give energy to first level consumer. First level consumer give energy to second level consumer. Second level consumer give energy to third level consumer. See here, the grass give energy to grasshopper. Grasshopper give energy to snake. Snake give energy to peacock or eagle. So this is the energy transfer from one and living things to another living thing. This is a food chain. Next, food web. Food web means many every organism can feed on different kinds of food. So a single organism will be a part of many food chain. Many connected food chain is a food web. Okay, food web. See here, the grass are eaten by small insect. Then now we see the example of food chain. See here, the grass, sorry, grass, grain, carrot. These are the plants. Okay, that eaten by rat, grains eaten by rat, eaten by grasshopper. Then these two things here eaten by grain. So the grains eaten by rat, rat eaten by snake. This is one food chain. Okay, then they get a snake. That is one food chain. Likewise, the grass eaten by grasshopper eaten by frog eaten by eagle. This is another food chain. So the two food chains are connected to form the food verb, the energy transferring. This is a food verb. The transfer of energy between the organism of different energy sources across through the food verb. This is a food verb. Then the man is a part of many food verb, because plant, we are also eat the plants and animals. So we also part in the one part of the food chain and food verb. So we also transferring energy from one things to another. This is a food chain. Children, thank you. I hope that you have to understand the concept of food chain and food verb. Thank you.